just want to welcome you guys out to gang night. Come on, are you guys excited to be live on our gang night? Come on, we're going to start off with a praise song. So go ahead and stand up, clap your hands, loosen up, because we're going to worship him tonight. There is a river where goodness flows. There is a fountain that drowns sorrows. There is an ocean, it's deeper than fear. The tide is rising, it's rising. There is a current stirring deep inside. It's overflowing from the heart of God. The flood of heaven crashing over us. The tide is rising, it's rising. It's bursting, bursting, bursting up from the ground. We feel it now. Oh, it's bursting, bursting up from the ground. We feel it now. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. Hey, we come alive. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. There is a river where goodness flows. There is a fountain that drowns sorrows. There is an ocean, it's deeper than fear. The tide is rising, it's rising. There is a current stirring deep inside. It's overflowing from the heart of God. The flood of heaven crashing over us. The tide is rising, it's rising. It's bursting, bursting, bursting up from the ground. We feel it now. Oh, it's bursting, bursting up from the ground. We feel it now. We come alive in the river. 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 Break open prison doors. Set all the captives free. Spring up a well. Spring up a well. Spring up a well. Spring up a well in me. Nothing can stop this joy. Nothing can stop this joy. We're dancing in the streets. Spring up a well. Spring up a well. Spring up a well. Spring up a well in me. Oh, we come alive. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. We come alive. Hey, we come alive. We come alive in the river. 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 I'm going ankle deep, waist deep, all the way in. I'm going ankle deep, waist deep, all the way in. I'm going all the way in. I'm going all the way in. I'm going all the way in. Hey, we come alive. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river. We come alive in the river.
Now, do you feel the Spirit of the Lord? We want to welcome you guys out to our gang night, your gang night. Come on, somebody. And right now, you know, what's up, gang girls and gang warriors? And right now, we just want to take the time. And I want to challenge you guys right now to tune in and like our video, share it, post it, repost it, tell your friends about it, you know, because you know how gang roll. We about it. So with that, you know, we just want to open up with a word of prayer. Amen. Heavenly Father, we come before you right now in the name of Jesus, Father God. Take full control, Father God. Take full control, Father God, of this service, Father God. In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen, gang. So at this time, we're just going to go ahead and worship God tonight.
So right there where you're at, just begin to worship him. It doesn't matter who's watching. It doesn't matter where you're at. Just begin to lift your hands and worship him.
Worship you, Jesus. We praise you, Lord. We love you, Jesus. There's no place I'd rather be. No place I'd rather be. No place I'd rather be than here. I'd rather be than hearing your love, hearing your love. So set a fire down in my soul. Here I am, Lord, take control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. Set a fire down in my soul. Here I am. I want more of you, God.
I want more of you, God.
There's no place, no place I'd rather be. No place I'd rather be. No place I'd rather be than here in your love.
Oh, there's no place, no place I'd rather be.
No place I'd rather be. No place I'd rather be than here in your love.
Here in
your love. Set a fire. Set a fire down in my soul. Here I am, Lord, take control. I want more of you, God. I want more. Set a fire. Set a fire down in my soul. Here I am, Lord, take control. I want more of you, God.
I want more of you, God.
Set a fire down in my soul. Here I am, Lord, take control. I want more of you, God.
Continue to worship him right there where you're at.
You are the way maker. You are.
You are here, moving in our midst. I worship you. I worship you. You are here. You're working in this place. I worship you.
Give you guys the announcements, gang. And on Sunday mornings, join us for service. Church done differently at 10 a.m. Bug your parents. Bug them. Tell them you want to watch it. Tune in. And at 6 p.m. as well, come back and join us again, gang. Get involved. And as well on Tuesdays, hit us up. We got life groups, man. We got life groups. 7 p.m. 7 p.m., man. Hit us up. Come on, new gen, high schools, YA, hit us up. It's all right. Don't be shy. 7 p.m., you know, for Zoom. Let's Zoom in, you know what I'm saying? Zoom in, gang. And then on Wednesdays as well, we also got midweek service. Come on, somebody. Midweek at 7 p.m. as well. Bug your parents. Don't wait for somebody to tell you. Tune in. Join us. Come on, gang. God's anointing our generation. Come on, man. Let's get involved, man. Let's get involved, man. And then also, don't forget, gang nights, 7 p.m. Just like right now, 7 p.m. Every Friday night, don't miss out. Tell your friends. So with that, I wanna call up Ozzy for the tithes and offering. Amen. Thank you, gang.
God bless you, gang. I pray you've been enjoying this time. Come on now. How many of us enjoy the worship? Come on now. And I believe that there's something special about worshiping God. There's something special about God's anointing now generation that knows how to commit not just their hands to lifting up Jesus, not just their voices singing the songs lifting up Jesus, but how many of us know there's another type of worship? We worship in our giving, come on now, of our tithes and our offerings. So God's anointing now generation, I hope you're ready here tonight. I got a scripture that I want to share, but I want to share real quick three ways to give. We have our traditional way, and an hour before our services and an hour after, we keep the church open so that way those who want to tithe and bring their tithe and their offerings to the actual location of the church, you're still able to do that. We'll have somebody here to receive your tithe and your offering. Also, we have our online giving. You could go online and you could give that way. Also, we have a new app. It's called Givelify, and you could download that app. You could go to victoryoutreachbarstow.com and you could find the app there. And it's called, again, Givelify, and it's an easy way of giving. You type in your information one time, and then all you have to do is tap on that app, and there it is. You type in what you want to give, and it goes right to it. And so that's a convenient way, and so we want to encourage you to do it that way. I know we're in a situation where we can't really be too mobile, but if that's the way that could work for you, I pray that you use it and you be blessed. But I have a scripture. It's found in Luke 6:38. It's a very familiar scripture for a lot of us, amen. But I want to use it in a way that's, come on now. I want to hit home with this, come on. I know a lot of us, God bless, come on, amen, during this, you could say, crisis, amen. But I believe God is doing something special in this time, and I'm going to go ahead and read the scripture, 6:38. Give, and it will be given unto you. Good measure, crushed down, full running over, they will give to you, for in the same measure as you give, it will be given to you again. How many of us received a 1,200? Amen. I know I wasn't the only one. Amen. But soon as I got it, I knew it was a challenge. I said, God, all right, what do you want me to do? I know there's a portion of scripture that says, out of the abundance, the heart speaks. Amen. But I wanted to do the same, not only for the speaking of my mouth, but for the speaking of my faith. And so it's something about stepping into faith, saying, you know what, God? I might have got this much, but I'm going to give you this much because you're worthy of it. Because I know I'm not, I could be expecting that over-measuring cup, but I don't want God just to overflow in my cup. I want God to overflow within my family, within my church, within my loved ones, within my city. That when we come out of this, come on now, we're going to see God pouring into everybody's cup. Because there's some givers God is raising up within God's anointing now generation. Come on, has he ever left you? Come on, has he ever forsaken you? His promise is to always be there. Amen, even to the end of the age. He ain't going nowhere. Ain't nothing going to keep us from God. Amen, ain't nothing going to separate us from his love. So let us not keep our love from him, amen. That next level in worship, amen. The tithe. That's 10 cents from a dollar. Come on now. $1 from 10. ain't nothing really, amen. But give God from your heart, amen. And so I want to pray for the offering, those that are giving tonight. You bow your head maybe where you're at. So, Father God, we just come before you, God, and we're just blessed, God, to give to you, God, to worship you here tonight. We understand, my God, oh, that you're calling us to a different level, God, with you, Father, and you want to take us to another level. So even now, I pray you bless those that give, that can give, God, and those that can give, God. I pray you show them, God, that you're able to provide. And as you provide, I pray you challenge them to give unto you, Lord, that we can never outgive you. But, God, there's another level, God, you're calling us to go to, my God, with you, God, with your love. And so I pray, show them who you are. Bless this offering, God, here tonight. Continue to have your way. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you here tonight, gang.
Many guys are still excited out there. I know we're not able to be here in actual church, right? But we're still able to have church at home, you know. So it's a privilege, you know, to see everybody that's tuned in. But tonight we have something special for you, amen. And we want to challenge everybody right there in your home. You know, if you feel like God's placing a special in your heart, you know, we encourage you, you know, to be sensitive to the voice in God and just follow through what he wants you to do. But tonight we have a special. Come on, now we have a special. We have a special, and it comes from our brother Ozzy. Come on now, and J.O. and Rennie. So they have a special song for you tonight, and I don't want to take too much of their time, but I hope you enjoy it. Amen. God bless.
Hallelujah. Y'all ready, gang? Hope y'all ready, gang, gang. Let's do this. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
One moment, we're going to start. But God bless you. Just continue to share right where you're at. If you have friends, you have loved ones that you want to hear the word today, because we came for the word. We came for worship. We came for a time not just to be entertained. I believe God has a word for you. So I want to encourage you. Amen. Share it with your friends. Share it with your loved ones. Facebook, YouTube, wherever you're at. Amen. But we want to bless you with a special song. Amen. So how many of us can relate to maybe being lost in the world? Maybe being lost at one time. Maybe you felt alone. Maybe you felt like there was no hope. I want to let you know that there's freedom in Jesus. There's hope in freedom. Jesus. Amen. And I believe there's freedom for some of you here tonight.
Yes. Yes.
And this song's for you.
For you.
There is freedom,
freedom.
In your presence, 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 there is.
Doctors, they find me and I feel so alone.
So alone.
Is there a love that can never bring me home?
Bring me home.
I don't understand why this road is so cold.
So cold.
Everyone's waiting for a love unknown. Doctors, they find me and I feel so alone.
So alone.
Is there a love that can never bring me home?
Bring me home.
I don't understand why this road is so cold.
So cold.
Everyone's waiting for a love unknown. See, doctors, they find me and I feel so alone.
So alone.
Is there a love that can never bring me home?
Bring me
and
home.
I don't understand why this road is so cold.
So cold.
Everyone's waiting for a love unknown. Say freedom,
freedom.
In your presence there is freedom,
freedom.
In your presence there is freedom,
freedom.
In your presence there is freedom,
freedom.
In your presence there is.
There's a pain in my heart and I wanna rip it out. I was high, I was drunk, trying to figure out what a love at, what a truth at. Everywhere I went, I got backstabbed. No trust, no love, it was like that. No sleep, tripping out like all bad. My daddy and my mama like all sad. Their beautiful home was a dope pad. Everything I owned was stolen, stolen.
Freedom, freedom. In your presence there is freedom,
freedom.
In your presence there is freedom,
freedom.
In your presence there is freedom,
freedom.
In your presence there is. Caught up in the misery, the song of my life. Got my heart broken now, thoughts of suicide. Hoping for a way out, so no, I cannot fly. Can anyone relate to this battle in my mind? The pressure coming over me, it's killing me inside. Taking me to places that I never thought I'd fly. I'm breaking into pieces, still hoping that I climb. Can anyone show me the better way to life? Said freedom,
freedom.
In your presence, there is freedom,
freedom.
In your presence, there is freedom,
freedom.
In your presence, there is freedom,
freedom.
In your presence, there is. I just wanna let you know,
let you know.
You don't have to feel alone.
No, no.
And I can see the pain in your eyes. Sin's been killing you, got you paralyzed. And I'm just here to let you know,
let you know.
Jesus is the way to hope.
Come on.
And he could really change you. Woo. He could break the chains too. He could take the old away. He could make you brand new.
Come
freedom.
On. Freedom.
In your presence there is freedom.
Freedom.
In your presence there is freedom.
Freedom.
In your presence there is freedom.
Freedom.
In your presence there's no other way to love. There's no other way to freedom. There's no other way to love. There's no other way to freedom. There's no other way to love. There's no other way to freedom. There's no other way to love. There's no other way to freedom. Freedom. In your presence there is freedom. In your presence there is freedom.
In your presence there is freedom. In your presence there is freedom.
John 8:35-36 says, now a slave has no permanent place in the family, but a son belongs to it forever. So if the son sets you free, you'll be free indeed. 2 Corinthians 3:17. Now the Lord is spirit, and where the spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. There's freedom for the depression.
Freedom.
There's freedom for those that are addicted. There's freedom for those that are lost. Come on now. There's freedom in his presence.
Freedom.
Freedom. In your presence, there is freedom.
Freedom.
Man, God bless you here tonight.
God bless you, gang.
I hope you were blessed, gang.
Come on.
No further more. We want to introduce you. You already know him. Come on out, my brother Edgar, our gang leader. Got the word coming to you, amen. God is doing something special within God's anointing now generation here at Barstow. Come on now. And those that are tuning in live, we want to let you know that God has a word for you. So let's prepare our hearts. Let's continue to share. If you haven't shared already, we want to encourage you to interact with us on the chat, the live chat, amen, Facebook, YouTube. Throw your emojis, your claps, your amens. We want to really just connect with all of you, amen. Like we were in the church setting, we want you to just pay attention tonight because I believe God has a word for you. Again, I'm going to call on my brother Edgar, amen. He's going to take it from here. God bless you, gang.
Amen. How many guys are excited out there? We just once again, we want to welcome you out to our Victory Outreach Gang Night service. Amen. And maybe sometimes when we're at home, you know, we have the TV on, you know, there's still a lot of activity going on, maybe distractions. So before we even start with the message, what I want to do is do your best to eliminate all those distractions. So before we even start the word, let's just get into an atmosphere
into a mindset of worship. So right there where you're at home, it's okay. Don't be afraid. It's okay to lift up your hands.
There's nothing
so right there in your home, I encourage you to give some worship to Jesus right now.
Nothing can compare.
Just let it be you and God right now.
You're our living hope. Your presence, Lord. Oh, I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves, where my heart becomes free and my shame is under in your presence.
Worship God. Continue to lift up your hands. I encourage you. Right there, maybe grab your little brother, maybe grab your little sister, whoever's around you. I encourage you to get your whole family to start worshiping God right now. Get your whole family to start lifting up their hands for the God, the God that gave you the victory, the God, the one that saved you, the God, the one that healed you. And I believe that tonight, he wants to do something special. So lift up your voice in. Lift up your voice to the God.
Your goodness, let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Oh, Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God.
Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord.
Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you right now, God, and we just place tonight into your hands, Lord. I place the message in your hands, God, and I'm believing, Lord, that you're going to speak right now, my God. I'm believing, God, that you're going to show insight to the people, that the people that are tuned in right now, it's the right timing for them, and I believe you have a special word for them, Lord. So I pray that you remove distractions away from me, maybe inside of their homes, maybe inside of their hearts, my God, maybe distractions inside of their minds, Lord. I'm believing, God, that you're going to do something great right now, my God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I place tonight into your hands, Lord. And I believe you're going to do miracles, God. I believe you're going to bring healing inside of the homes right now, my God. In the name of Jesus, take full control. Amen. Amen. Right there where you're at, just go ahead and interact with our
with our YouTube channel and our Facebook chat. Man, I want to encourage you to put your thumbs up. Come on now, put your waving hands. You know, you can even put your prayer request. And we're believing that God wants to do something beautiful in the city of Barstow. And I just pray that we're sensitive and we have our full focus on God tonight. Amen. Because I believe that just because we're not in church, we're still able to have church at home. Now, that's a beautiful thing. So with that being said, I don't want to waste too much time. Amen. But amen. Thank you to the worship team. Awesome team. Amen. Awesome team. So tonight I have the privilege to be speaking, to be bringing the word of God. And it's an honor and a privilege to be back here. Amen. But before we even start, if you haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel or you haven't liked our Facebook page, I encourage you to do that. Tag all your friends list and forward it to everybody. You know, let's not hold back the word of God. Amen. Well, first of all, before we even get into the message, I just want to say that I'm grateful. I'm grateful to God for my salvation. I'm grateful to God that what he pulled me out of, you know, because I'm no longer that man what I used to be. And the only one that was able to do that was God. You know, so I'm thankful for God coming into my life, for someone introducing God into me. And I also want to thank God for our founders, Pastor Sonny and Sister Julie. Amen. They did a beautiful thing with this ministry. And it's a wonderful privilege, you know, to be following their exampleship. I also want to thank God for our pastor, Pastor Abel and Sister Raina, for all the hard work that they're doing. Come on, all the hard work that they're doing, you know, just I'm grateful for them and for them allowing me to even come to the Barstow Church, coming into the home. And I also want to thank God for the gang team. Amen. The gang team. Every single one of them, from Ozzy to Cali to J.O., you know, I'm thankful. And I also want to thank God for everybody that's tuning in, because I don't believe that it's just Barstow tuning in, amen. I believe that everybody else from different parts of the world are tuning in tonight. So I'm grateful, and it's a privilege to be speaking. But I want to share something with you, and you can find it in Mark chapter 4, verse 1. And it speaks about the parables of the four seeds, title of my message, amen. And while you guys get there, I'm going to open up with the word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you right now, Lord, and you just take full control, my God. I pray that you will minister to every single person that's tuned in, that you will show us, Lord, what it means about the four seeds, God, the parable, my God, of the land that the seed gets thrown on them, and the seed itself, Lord. You move in a special way, God. In the name of Jesus, amen. And the word of God reads, again, Jesus began to teach by the lake. The crowd that gathered around him was so large that he got into a boat and sat in it out on the lake, while all the people were along the shore at the water's edge. And here it goes. He taught them many things by parables, and his teaching said, listen, a farmer went out to sow his seed. As he was scattering the seed, some fell along the path, and the birds came and ate it up. Some fell along rocky places where it did not have much soil. It sprang up quickly because the soil was shallow. But when the sun came up, the plant was scorched and they withered because they had no root. Other seed fell along thorns, which grew up and choked the plant so that they did not grow grain. Still other seed fell on good soil and came up, grew and produced a crop, some multiplying 30, some 60, some a 30 times. Then Jesus said, whoever has ears to hear, let him hear. When he was alone, the 12 and the other around him asked him about the parable. He told them, the secrets of the kingdom of God have been given to you, but those outside, everything is said in a parable, so that they may be ever seen but never perceiving,
and ever hearing but never understanding. Otherwise, they may turn and be forgiven. So before we even get into this, I just want to share a quick story. You know, the way this word ministered to me, and I'm gonna be honest and I'm gonna be real. You know, I was battling with this message. I was going back and forth with God. Come on, I was going back and forth with God. I was like, God, Lord, are you sure this is the right message? And He keeps telling me yes, and I'm like, Lord, I need more confirmation, right? And He keeps telling me yes. He keeps telling me yes. You know, and it was and I kind of was shocked the way it ministered to me, because one of the leaders in the church, right, David, you know, he was making a garden. He was growing a garden, right, and he was just starting it off. And I was thinking it was going to be something quick, which it wasn't. You know, it was a little process, you know, but I'm thankful that he invited me to do that, you know. But so that's when it really started ministering to me. And then throughout the whole week, it was really ministering to me. I kept hearing about this parable about the four seeds. And I was trying to tell God, like the last 2 days, like, look, Lord, I'll just do something else. I got something else. He's telling me, no, I need you to speak this word. Amen. So just being obedient. Why does God speak in parables, right? The parable is basically an earthly story with a heavenly meaning, right? God relates it to something that we can relate to. Jesus used parables to explain to his followers and the disciples how there are different responses to the saving gospel. And the parables, right? And I just want to share just a little bit, an intro of the parables. The parables are also conceal the truth to those who are too stubborn, right? Or maybe too lazy, right, to figure it out, or maybe even spiritually prideful. You know, so I started really looking at things and what's the meaning of the seed and the soils, right? The seed is the word of God, and the soil is the response of the hearts of the people. What potential does the seed carry, right? And I like to look at Matthew chapter 17, verse 20. He replied, because you have so little faith, truly I tell you, if you have faith small as a mustard seed, you can tell this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you. And I applied this scripture to the potential of the seed, right? Because if you really look at it, a mustard seed is so small. But when you really do a study behind it, you know, it grows up to be something so great. And he compared it to our faith. If you have little faith, come on now, if you have little faith, you know, you can move mountains. You know, this is how all the plants start, right? They come from a seed, right? It's basically a plant that's enclosed and protected with the outer covering. And I like to look at this because it's able to plant. A plant, right, is able to produce life. Something that's so little, right, is able to create something so big. Amen. So God, what God was doing with this parable, right, the sower, I mean, God is throwing the word of God out there, but he wants to know which land are we. Come on now, God is searching for some good land. God is searching for some good soil. Amen. And we're gonna be able to see all four of them, where all these four seeds landed. The word of God is being scattered, right? But how are we gonna respond to it? Amen. My first point is the first seed. Listen, a farmer went out to sow his seed, and as he was scattering the seed, some fell along the path, and the birds came and ate it up. Some people are like the seed along the path where the word is sown, and as soon as they hear it, Satan comes and takes away the word that was sown in them. The path is a way beaten, right? Is a way beaten, formed, or stepped on by the feet of a person or animal, right? And this seed, it just landed on the surface, and I like to look at the soil, right, where the land which the seed was thrown on, where this is the class of people, right, where they take the word of God lightly, right? They took the word of God lightly, where, and sometimes I like to
I like to look at it because it wasn't really it's not like the word of God cannot penetrate and cannot do miracles, right? And it's not able to do great things, right? But it was more of the land, which where it landed. It was more of the seed where it landed. And this class of person, right, the way God ministered to me is they have their guards up, right? They made maybe certain things that weren't allowing the word of God to come in and effectively change their life. Right, because you can see it in Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. For the word of God is alive and active, sharper than any double-edged sword, and it penetrates even through the divine, dividing the soul and the spirit, joints and marrow, and it judges the thoughts of the attitude of the heart. And to be honest, it's not the word of God, like I said. It's not the word of God that's not able to change. It was the land which it landed on, right? These were hearers, right? But they didn't receive it right away because they didn't protect it right away because they didn't protect the seed, right? Right away because they weren't protectors of the seed. The enemy came and devoured it. And the word of God was never meant to be devoured. It wasn't even so much the word, right? Because when the sower threw it, the birds came and ate it, right? So it's not really God's fault. It was our fault because we weren't protecting the word. Come on now, because the word of God gets given to us every Sunday, every midweek, every Friday night, every Tuesday, every Monday. You know, with Bethy classes, it always gets transmitted to us. But what are we doing with the word of God? The word, like I like to look at the land, right? And this is the land. This is how it ministered to me. Where this land, right? It was mistreated, right? Unprotected, stepped on, abused, pressed, right? Controlled. And these are some of the signs where the land, where you know when the seed lands on a path. Maybe your heart's been hardened, right, through past experiences, right, through difficult times, or whatever it may be, that the word of God is not, you're not allowing it fully in. You're not allowing it to come in and to do something inside of your life. Or maybe it can be trust issues. Amen. It can be trust issues where you feel people done you wrong. Maybe you feel that, maybe it can even be in ministry, right, where your guards are all the way up. But I like to look at this. How can we take care of this path? Because maybe there's some of us, maybe you can be in ministry for a long time, and maybe you can get to this point. You can even get to this point where your heart gets hardened, or maybe you're just hurt. Or maybe you just don't really feel too inspired to do ministry or inspired to do church, right? But how can we take care of the path, right? And I like to look at this. We must put it through a process. Amen. Because if you look at this land, you gotta check the land to see if it's good for producing. And this is the way I look at it. When you have leaders looking at you, you know, when they're asked if they can work with you, we have to be open to it, right? The second step you have to do is you have to toil the ground, right? That means you have to start breaking old ways. You have to allow your leaders to come into your life and start breaking the old habits. Start doing a great thing inside of you. Start investing in you. Right? After you toil the ground, you loosen up the dirt, right? You take the chunks of roots that are remaining. And I like to look at it like this, because it's like a leader removing everything that's unnecessary, anything that can affect your life. Because some of us, sometimes we don't even know what's good for ourselves, right? Because all of our lives we've been feeding our negativity. All of our lives we've been feeding nothing but the nonsense. But once our leaders start coming in and start working with us, you know, we like to put our guards up. We like to push away. We don't like to call them back, right? And I like to look at this, the fourth step, and this all has to relate with the path. Take the roots out. Any attachments, and this you can look at it like this, any attachments that you have to the world, you have to disconnect to that. Amen. You have to disconnect yourself from any attachments. Take away those roots that are killing your spirit. Take away those roots that are ruining your life. You got to add some nutrient. Come on, now you got to bring the word of God in the mix. Amen, because it's not going to be people that change you. It's going to be the word of God that changes you. Amen. And then you gotta the seed's just not thrown and put in there. You gotta mount it, amen. Like I said, you gotta let the word of God grow you. And you gotta take care of it. That's maintenance. Being accountable to your leaders, right? Cultivating the victory outreach concept. Amen. The second land I want to look at is the rocky places, right? Unsteady, difficult, or uncertain, full of hazards or obstacles. Some fell on rocky places where it did not have much soil. It sprang up quickly because the soil was shallow. But when the sun came up, the plant was scorched and they withered because they had no root. Others, like the seed sown on the rocky places, hear the word, but once receive it with joy. But since they did not have no roots, it only lasted for a short time. When trouble and persecution came because of the word, they quickly fell away. Amen. I pray someone's receiving something. Amen. Out there in our Victory Outreach YouTube channel and our Facebook. And this is the type of people, or you can say land, right? Where they're moved for the moment. They're moved, right? When they hear that worship song, when they hear that praise song, when they come to the altar and they start jumping and they start shouting and they're moved with joy, right? And they're moved for the moment. But when the trials and the problems come on now, I said when the trials and the problems comes, all of a sudden they get shaky. All of a sudden, right, they're not able to handle that pressure. And these are the signs when you will know when it lands on rocky places. For a moment they catch it, but then it fades away. It's just for a brief moment. For the hype, right? They jump and shout. They jump and shout in the service and a great altar call. But then on a Monday, they go back to their normal life, to the normal routine. Amen. And I pray it's not, you don't see it as a rebuking, amen, because this is the way God gave it to me, and I just want to bring it forward. Amen. Amen. Another one is when you're on rocky places, right? It's when you're like a part-time Christian. Come on out, a part-time Christian. And when you're a part-time Christian, right, I'm going to tell you right now that the full-time demons, they're going to push you out of the church. They're going to push you out of your calling. They're going to push you out of this ministry, right? Another sign when you would know when it lands on a rocky place, it wasn't thought out, right? It was just a spur of the moment. Hey, yeah, I'll do that for you, right? Yeah, no, I'll go over there and I'll do that for you. Don't even worry, right? But they didn't really count the cost that's going to come. They didn't count the spiritual attack. They didn't count none of that behind everything that they were doing. So like it says, they got pushed away by the trials and the persecutions. And how can we take care of this rocky place? Amen. We have to take the rocks out the way, right? We have to move our hype to a commitment level. We have to start digging, right, and go a little deeper, which that means it's not just ankle deep, right? We're talking about going all the way in. We're talking about, you know, taking this to a next level. Maybe there's some of you out there that's struggling with certain things like this. But I want to let you know that tonight, God's going to give you your breakthrough. That tonight, God's going to give you something that you can hold on to and that you can apply it to your life. You know, like I said, you can start digging and go deep. Allow the roots to start going deep. It's not too late. Maybe you find yourself in different places, but it's not too late to get to good soil, which we'll be getting there. The third main point is the thorn, something that wounds. That just ministered to me completely, amen. Still another, like seed sown among thorns. Hear the word, but the worries of its life, the deceitfulness of wealth, and the desires of other things come in and choke the word, making it unfruitful. And the way God ministered to me on this one, it was more like, it wasn't so much of the land, but it was how the seeds started growing. Because it started growing around some thorns. Come on, I started growing around some things that are toxic, right? Some things that are dangerous,
some things that are not healthy, right? Where this caused it to be choked out. Where this caused it to be choked out. And if you don't abide, right, in John chapter 15, verse 4, abide in me and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine. Either can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine. You are my branches. Whoever abides in me, I in him. He it is that bears much fruit. For apart from me, you cannot do nothing. Amen. I like to look at this thorns, right, as the environment. The environment. Because sometimes we can have good intentions, right? Sometimes we can have great intentions. And it can be a great church service. And it can be an awesome gang night. And it can be just something so great. But when you go back home, the environment that you're in, it's more dangerous. It has more of an influence on you, right? Or sometimes it's just you want to do good, but you continue to surround yourself. You continue to have that environment of people or whatever you want to call it, right? But I say people that continue to drag you down, continue to cause pain, where you're surrounded by this for so long that it's caused pain. Now you're starting to walk around, cause pain to other people. And if you're not connected to the vine, right, you're disconnecting yourself from the body. So these are the signs that when it lands among thorns, because you like to look at the environment, the desires of the flesh can get in the way, right? Pleasures of the flesh, right? In the moment it's good, but in the long run it ruins you. Distractions, right? But you feed yourself on social media, but you feed yourself the people you hang out with, the negative energy, right? And how can we take care of the thorns? Surround yourself around the right people. That's it. Let's just do that, amen? And now I'd like to call the worship team up. The fourth one is the good soil. Still other seeds fell on good soil. It came up, grew, and produced a crop. Some multiplied 30, some 60, some 100 times. Others like seeds sown on good soil. Hear the word, accept it, and produce a crop. Some 30, some 60, some 100 times what was sown. Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord, who trusts is the Lord. He is like a tree planted by the water and sends out roots by the stream and does not fear when heat comes or its leaves remain green or is not anxious in the year of drought, for it does not cease to bear fruit. And this is what a good soil does. Amen. This is high quality. This is high quality. The ground as producing, as cultivating for crops. But right away, you're faithful to your process. Right away, you come in, and maybe you have some bumps. Maybe you have some hiccups on the road. And maybe you were on that path. Or maybe you were on the next to the thorns, right? But you're able to remove that, right? You're able to say, you know what? Maybe I am a thorn right now. And maybe I am on that path. Maybe I'm not allowing the word of God to come in and effectively change my life. Well, then guess what? Maybe you can tell yourself, tell your family right there in your home. I want to be good soil. I want to be that soil, right? Because you know what the good soil does? It produces. You know what the good soil does? It disciples, right? What the good soil does, it catches the vision. Where you can look at it, I've been tolling, right? I've been working with my heart. I've been going through the process. And I'm ready to receive the word.
I'm tired of being like the other path. I'm tired of being like the rocky places. I'm tired of being unsteady, right? Undependable. Where I'm not able to be called on. I want to be that good soil. And I want to let you know that tonight, that's going to happen, right? Because when you're good soil, you're all in. When you're good soil, the first thing you wake up on, you wake up with Jesus on your mind. When you're good soil, all you want to do is you want to put a smile on God's face. When you're good soil, you're willing to lay it all down for a stranger. Come on now. For that neighbor. For the one, that homeless person that maybe you don't know, but you feel it heavy in your heart to give him something. You feel it heavy in your heart to minister to him. A good soil was sold out to this vision, sold out to the cause that God places on your heart. And how can we keep this alive? You got to stay hungry. You got to stay open and available. Stay close to your leaders. And amen, just right there where you're at, if you can stand, right there in your home. Because I believe God gave me this word. And I know, and I'm confident in God, that when he gave me this word, it's doing something out there. So if that's you, and you know it's you, don't be afraid to let God speak to you right now. It doesn't matter if you're around all these people. Maybe you feel afraid to lift up your hands in front of your family. I want to encourage you. Let God speak to you right now. With that being said, just let it be you and God right now. That you want his will to be complete in your life. Maybe there's some out there that made mistakes in life. But I'm here to let you know tonight, God's able to change that. He's able to change a path to good soil. He's able to uproot those thorns. But I want to let you know, stick to the process that God has you under. Tell God right now you want to be that good soil. Tell God right now that you want everything that He has for your life, that He has for your family, that He has for your future. So right there where you're at, continue to lift up your hands. Continue to cry out to Him, because I believe there's people out there that's good soil. I believe that there's a God's anointed now generation, that they're good soil, that they're ready to be worked with, that they're ready to give their whole life for somebody just to be reached. And maybe you can be doing ministry for so long, and you find yourself in one of those paths. I'm telling you, God's able to switch that to good soil.
Let it be, I surrender. Everything I am, I give over. I open
right there where you're at in your home. Maybe you're in your car. Like I said, I felt it heavy on my heart for me to share this word with you. And if you're tuning in, I just want you to repeat this prayer after me. And I don't want you to say it under your breath. I want you to say it loud so people hear that. Say, Father God, I admit I am a sinner, and I believe You died on the cross for me and rose on the third day. And I confess You as my Lord and Savior. Turn me into good soil, God. Let Your will be completed. In the name of Jesus, amen. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before You right now, God, and I just pray, Lord, and I ask, God, that maybe someone tuned in, Lord, needed to hear this word, God, and I pray for their breakthrough, God. Maybe they find themselves on the thorns, on a rocky place, on a path, God. I believe, Lord, that You're able to put them through a process to bring them back to good soil, God. I thank You, Lord, for what You're doing. I thank You for victory outreach, God. And I pray that You continue to anoint us, Lord, to reach the world for Your glory, God. In the name of Jesus, we place the word in Your hands. And I pray, Lord, that You seal it in their hearts, my God. In the name of Jesus, then all the glory be to You, my God. In the name of Jesus, amen. Amen. So from wherever city you're tuned in from, I want to encourage you that next week we will be having our gang night, and we will be having something special. Amen. So I encourage you to tune in. Also, we have our Sunday service at 10 a.m. and our Rise Up service at 6 p.m. With that being said, we just pray that you enjoy the rest of your night. God bless.